Hey everyone, my name's Nathan Pei and welcome to Blu Ocean Crypto. Okay, so today we're going to show you how to set up a Wax wallet. Of course, we'll make sure we have all the official links down in the description below. You can use a variety of different accounts that you may already have in order to start a Wax wallet. You can also just sign up directly through the Wax website, which will let you choose your own username and password. We all hate bots, and in order to prevent bots from creating new wallets on the Wax network, Wax will require us to send some of its native token to the newly created wallet. Step 1. Get some Wax. If you're unsure which exchange can help facilitate the purchase, I recommend CoinGecko. At the bottom of the page, you'll find a group of popular exchanges that list the Wax token. Typically, you'll want to look at the 24-hour trade volume. The higher the trade volume, the easier it is to purchase. I'm going to use Binance. Let's hop over to our Binance account. I'm actually just going to buy some Bitcoin and swap the Bitcoin for Wax, and I'll show you why. If you just try to purchase the Wax token directly, you'll notice it can't be done. This is done through the convert feature on the main page with our Bitcoin. Now that we've swapped our Bitcoin for Wax, we can see the Wax token in our wallet under Fiat and Spot. Step 2. Let's go back over to the Wax wallet and start the setup process. As I've mentioned before, you can either set up a new account or use an account that you have already set up on another platform. I'm going to use my Google account, but use the one that best suits you. I've gone through the terms of service multiple times, so I'll spare you the trouble now. But it's important that you read them when you first create your wallet. Last I checked, I'm over the age of 18. Step 3. Send Wax to your new wallet. Now that we're in our new wallet, we'll need to send some Wax to it in order to get started. As you can see here, we're being prompted to send a minimum of 5 Wax with a memo to the funding address provided. There is a Coinbase option if you deal with that particular exchange. Since we're using Binance, we'll just use the information provided here. Let's hop back onto Binance and we'll be making a withdrawal. Again, you'll find the tokens in your wallet under Fiat and Spot. Select the withdraw option next to your Wax token. Take the time to read any prompts or messages you're presented. I'll cancel this for now. If I can offer one piece of advice, be patient. Ensure that all the information we input here is correct. Next, we'll need to select the network. Nice and easy. It's reminding us we'll need to attach the memo. Simply copy and paste the memo provided by Wax. Let's double check and make sure we have all the fields filled out correctly. Okay, great. As I mentioned earlier, we'll need to send a minimum of 5 Wax. However, in a future video, we're going to be using this account to make purchases, so I'm sending all of it. Again, it pays to be patient. Read all prompts. Once in a blue moon, Binance will ask you to answer a few verification questions. One final prompt, as we are both the sending and receiving parties, I can verify there's no risk of fraud. The withdrawal might result in the loss of funds, funds cannot be recovered, do we want to proceed? Yes, we're aware of that. Before the withdrawal happens, Binance will have us confirm the details of the transaction. We'll be sending a total of 198 Wax because there's a network fee of 2 Wax. We can see here that the information matches up, just be sure to double check before moving forward. Almost there. We just have to do a quick 3-part verification via email, phone, and the Authenticator app. All right, we've submitted our withdrawal request, as you can see here, and we'll receive an email confirmation as soon as the request goes through. It can take up to 12 hours for the transaction to process. This is dependent on the network, but in my experience, this tends to be relatively quick.
A few moments later.
As you can see here, the transaction is complete and we have our Wax in our Wax wallet. You may be asking yourself, I thought we sent 200 Wax. You're not wrong. However, if you remember, there's the 2 Wax network fee from Binance and also the 5 Wax needed to set up the new account. So, after 7 Wax in fees, as you can see, we have the remaining 193 Wax left in our Wax wallet. Perfect. Step 4, adding resources to your wallet. In order to utilize your Wax wallet on the network, you're gonna have to add some resources over in this resource section. The Wax network uses a staking mechanism to offset your activity on the network. The more active you are on the network, the more you'll need to stake. Our advice would be to start with 50 Wax for the CPU and both 5 Wax for net and RAM. If you ever need to add more Wax to your CPU, net, or RAM, this is where you'll do it. Now that we have set up our Wax wallet and staked some resources, we are now ready to explore the Wax network. But before we do, let's enable two-factor authentication. Click the cogwheel down in the bottom right of your Wax dashboard in order to access the settings. It's under account security that you'll be able to enable the 2FA. This is important because it will help prevent fraudulent activity should someone gain access to your account. There are a lot of great play-to-earn titles and NFT collectibles on the Wax network. Let us know in the comments below what you're checking out, and as always, be sure to like, subscribe, and hit that bell notification so you never miss a beat. Cheers.